हेलो एवरीवन, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर थर्ड सेशन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 6 टिश्यूज. सो प्रीवियसली वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यूज, ओके, व्हिच इज द मेन वन ऑफ द मेन टाइप ऑफ द प्लांट टिश्यूज. एंड इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द सेकंड मेन टाइप, दैट इज द परमानेंट टिश्यू. इन दैट अगेन देयर आर टू सब टाइप्स, सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यू एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स. In the third session, we will complete simple permanent tissues. But before that, we will revise the meristematic tissues that we have learned previously. Okay, as there is a technical problem, due to that, I am not able to show the slides. So you can see now. Okay, so these are the meristematic tissues which are present in the apical, intercalary and lateral. Means according to the position, there are three types of meristematic tissues: apical, intercalary and lateral. Previously we have learned that the position means their location and their functions that I have mentioned in this slide. So you can see here the apical meristematic tissues, where is the location and what are the functions. So all these things I have given in this slide, so you can take screenshot and then complete your short notes. See the positions: apical, which is the tip of the stem and the roots; intercalary, that is sides of the stem and the stem, or what you can say that, at the base of the leaves and the internodes, that are the intercalary; and lateral, that within the stem and the roots. Okay, so through this I have told to write the short notes, but maybe you don't have this slide, because as I have told, because of the technical issues. So again, take the screenshot of this slide also and then complete your short notes regarding meristematic tissues. Means what are the tissues, their types, their location and their functions. Clear? So let's start our third session about the permanent tissues. So meristematic tissues, we have learned that these are the growing tissues. Okay, those are the growing tissues. Means they are having rapidly dividing cells. Now opposite to that, there are the permanent tissues. Means they are not having the dividing cells. Okay, these are the non-growing tissues. So if the question is there, write a note on the non-growing tissues. So non-growing tissues means what? Your permanent tissues. Clear? So first point in this session is how our permanent tissues are formed. So see, meristematic cells keep dividing and growing. Okay, they keep dividing and growing themselves until they reach a stage where they lose their ability to divide. Means each and every cell is having a particular capacity. When the capacity is finished, the cell will not able to divide or grow. So this process is called as a differentiation. Means when the meristematic tissues lost their capacity to divide, to grow, so this process is called as differentiation. Means from the life to the death, like that the process is there. And this process is called differentiation, which leads to the formation of permanent tissues. Means from the growing cells, they are converting into the non-growing cells. Clear how the permanent tissues are formed? When meristematic tissues stop to do their functions, okay, so that is differentiation. And due to that process, there is a formation of permanent tissues. Clear? That much easy. When meristematic tissues stop to grow, stop to divide, so there is the formation of permanent tissues. So once the cells of meristematic tissues divide to a certain extent, they become specialized for a particular function. Means what we can say that when the differentiation of meristematic tissues leads to the formation of permanent tissue. Okay, means when the cells stop dividing, they become specialized after performing their function. Now they are having स्पेशल एबिलिटी. क्लियर व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? सो ऑल दिस फॉर्मेशन इज डिपेंड अपॉन द डिफरेंशिएशन. व्हेन मेरिस्टेमेटिक टिश्यू स्टॉप्ड टू ग्रो देन देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ परमानेंट टिश्यूज. ओनली दैट मच यू हैव टू लर्न. एंड व्हेन मेरिस्टेमेटिक टिश्यूज रीच एट अ पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट एट अ पर्टिकुलर एक्सटेंट so they become specialized for their particular function. As we have learned that each and every cell or each and every group of cell is having a particular function only. They will not interfere with other functions. Okay? So that are the permanent tissues. So in permanent tissues we have seen there are two types, simple and complex. So now in this session we will learn only simple tissues for avoiding your confusion. Okay, but again in simple tissues again there are four types: parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma and the epidermis. Okay, so one by one we will start. Don't be afraid that how much we will learn these things and all. So you can learn, just do logically. Okay, I know that how much cell types are there, all the functions, all the structures you have to remember, but you can do it. Okay, so don't be afraid of these things. Make a table and then start it to learn. Don't learn the essay. Don't learn all the points. From these slides, make a table and then start it to learn. I will send you the table. Okay, but first you have to try to write. Okay, so see, in simple tissues, first type is parenchyma simple tissues. Okay, so these tissues are found in all the soft parts of the plant. Okay, wherever the soft parts are there, in that these parenchyma simple tissues will present. Now, why these are the simple tissues? Simple tissues means what? Only one type of cells are present here. Got it? Only one type of cells, as we have learned in chemical compound, in chemical element. Okay? Got it? Yes. So in simple tissues, why they are simple? Why the tissues are known as simple tissues? Because whatever the cells are present, so that cells are of same type. Only one type of cells are present. That's why they are simple tissues. Okay? So parenchyma simple tissues means what? There are also the cells which are of same type. And they are found in the soft parts of the plant. Okay? Clear? So these cells of parenchyma tissues are live. Okay? These are the living cells. Then see the structure. They are oval, elongated, loosely packed with large intercellular space forming basic packing of tissues and are found throughout the plant body. Means what? See, these tissues are made up of living cells. Okay, these tissues are made up of living cells, means the cells are live. And what is the structure? They are oval, elongated and loosely packed with large intercellular space. See, remember about the matter, solid, liquid and gas. In solid, there is no space. In liquid, there is a little bit space. In gases, there is so much space. Okay? So, in case of cells, we will see. This is what? Intercellular space. So the space between the two cells is called as the intercellular space. So whatever the parenchyma tissues are there, in that whatever the cells are present, they are present with the space. Okay? And they are found throughout the plant body. Clear? We will see the diagram. Okay? First we will see the theory and then we will go towards the diagram. See, what are the functions of parenchyma? Now these tissues are present throughout the body of the plant. Whenever the soft parts are there throughout the plant, these tissues are present. So what is the function? Main function? Yes, the main function is it provides mechanical support to the plant body. Okay, it provides support to the plant. It stores food, nutrients or water. So these are the functions of the parenchyma simple tissues. Clear? Clear? Okay. Next is about collenchyma simple tissues. So these simple tissues are formed in the are found in the petioles, in the leaves, and in the young stems, means when the plant is growing. Okay, like young, then aged people are there, no? So like that, there are young plant and the aged plants are there. So these collenchyma cells are found in petioles, in leaves, and in the young stems. Okay, then structure, these are also living cells. Like the parenchyma cells, these cells are also living cells. These tissues are having living cells. Same structure, that they are oval, elongated, but only difference is between the space. See, in parenchyma, there is a large intracellular space. But in case of collenchyma, they are tightly packed. Means there is no intercellular bed. Wait a minute. Okay, so there is no intercellular spaces. Clear? And they are found below the epidermis in leaves and stem. Now what is the epidermis? That we will see at the last. Okay? But maybe, I think I have told this in live session, epidermis. Have you remembered that? Epidermis means whatever the layer is there of our skin. So that is called as epidermis. Okay, so that we will see at last. So just remember that this collenchyma, the structure, location and the functions. Now see what is the functions. They provide mechanical support to the plant. Okay, means actually what they are giving the flexibility to the plants. No, when there is a wind, the plants are moving. Okay, they can bend without breaking. So because of whom? Because of the collenchyma tissues. Okay, these tissues give plants flexibility. That's why your stems, then the leaves of the plants are moving, can bend without breaking. So that is because of the collenchyma's simple tissues. Clear? So you can see here the simple permanent tissue that we have learned, parenchyma and collenchyma. So you can see here is a less intercellular space. Okay? Wait 1 minute. Okay, they are found below the epidermis. These are found in epidermis. So you can see alive means the living cells, elongated and irregularly thick, means there is no any proper structure. Okay, so this parenchyma and collenchyma are giving flexibility in plants. Clear? Third part of the simple tissues, that about the sclerenchyma tissues, which are opposite to above, means above cells or above tissues are made up of living cells, but the sclerenchyma simple tissues, they are made up of dead cells. So where they will found? Whatever the hard parts are there. So in the hard parts we will get the sclerenchyma tissues. Okay, so they are made up of dead cells. They are very long and narrow cells, and the walls are there. That walls are thickened with the lignin. One chemical is there that are present in the tissues. So see, we will read one by one sentence and then I will explain. Cells of sclerenchyma are dead. Okay, so these tissues are made up of dead cells. They are narrow and elongated. So this is the structure. And the cell wall in scleroderma is composed of lignin, which makes it hard. I have told you, these tissues are found in all the hard parts of the plant. Because of whom? Because of the lignin. Okay? And where we will get this? So these tissues are found around vascular bundles, veins of the leaves in hard covering of seeds and nuts. So you can check here, seeds and nuts, hard parts of the plant. For example, I have given that scleroderma tissues are found in coconut husk. Okay, the hard structure is because of whom? Because of these tissues. Clear? See the functions. They help to make parts plant hard and stiff. So no need to remember. If they are found in the hard part of the plant, so because of whom? Because of the scleroderma. And these tissues are also provides the mechanical strength. Got it? So since this is a hard tissue, it provides strength to the plant, also protect the parts like the seeds. For example, we have learned that the coconut husk. Okay? So you can see here, these are the microscopic images. So parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. So if you will see the cells in the microscope, through the microscope, so you will get this kind of structures. Okay, so see, colenchyma, parenchyma and sclerenchyma, the spaces or the cell walls given. So see, these are the cell walls. See how the intercellular spaces are there. And cell walls with lignin. Okay, this. So because of the lignin, these are the hard tissues. Okay, completed. Am I going fast? Okay. We will revise this all the tissues in live session only. So live session also. So don't confused. And the last part, that is the protective tissues. And these are the main tissues, or we can say that important tissues. Because below the epidermis, whatever we have learned, parenchyma, colenchyma, so that tissues are present below these protective tissues. So that's why these protective tissues are important, because they are protecting. The main function is the protection. Okay, these protective tissues are providing protection to the each and every body part of the plant. Okay, that's why the tissues are called as protective tissue. No, yes, so they protect the plant body by forming an outer layer. As the human body is having skin, imagine your body without skin. Can you imagine? All the bones we can see, then the structure, inner structure we can see. No? It is very horrible, no? So the skin is important for protecting our internal organs. So like that, plant also required a particular layer. So that are the epidermis tissues. Okay, that is the epidermis. The layer is called epidermis. Because of whom? Because of the protective tissues. But again, in the protective tissues, there are two types. So much tissues, no? I have to also learn these tissues before teaching you. Okay? So see, again in the protective tissues, there are two types, that are epidermis and cork tissues. So epidermis means what? So in short, we will learn. Yeah, these are the important, but see, the epidermis tissues covers the entire body of plant, means the outer layer we can see of the plant. So that is made up of epidermis simple tissues. So what are they doing? They protect the plant from the injury, from the germs and from the water loss. As we are doing evaporation, correct? We are also throwing water, the extra excessive salt, excessive water through the sweat and all. Correct? So like that, plants are also doing this, that is transpiration. Okay? But if the transpiration is in excess amount, that will affect the health of the plant. So that is protected by the epidermis simple tissues. Okay. So these epidermis tissues are found in roots, in leaves. Okay. Then in desert plants, in mature plants. Correct. So main function is that protect the plant body. That's it. So these cells of epidermal tissue form a continuous layer without intercellular spaces. As they are protecting the plant, there are no spaces in between the cells. Clear? Okay. So see, stomata are small openings on epidermal layer of a leaf and soft part of the stem to facilitate the gaseous exchange and transpiration in plants. So each stomata is composed of two guard cells that you have learned previously, which regulate the opening and closing of stomata. Okay, so we have to also throw water from the body. Plant also required, but not in excess amount. So all these things are controlled by the epidermis simple tissues. That's it. Okay, but whatever the gaseous exchange is there, whatever the water exchange is there, that is due to the stomata, which is also present in the epidermis. Clear? See, in desert plant, epidermis and the cutin. Maybe you have seen that the lotus leaf. Have you seen the lotus leaf? If you put the water, it will not stay on that leaf. Because of what? Because a waxy layer is present. A wax is present on the leaf. Okay, so because of that epidermis, means that layer, that cutin, it reduces the loss of water due to transpiration. See, in desert already there is less water, and if there is a transpiration through the plants will die. So who will protect the plants from the transpiration? That epidermis. Clear? And the second type in the protective tissues, that is cork simple tissues. These are having the dead cells. There are also no spaces. Okay. And they form the outer layer of old tree trunks. Old tree trunks. Okay. So, what we can say that? Remember properly. These epidermis tissues, that covers the entire body of plant. Okay, but there is no any means young or dead, but young or old. But the cork simple tissues, they are forming the outer layer of old tree trunks. Maybe you have seen that. Okay, so why the cork tissues are important? These tissues are also protect the plant from the injuries, germs and the water loss. Okay, so in the cork cells, there is one chemical that is called as suberin. Okay, so this suberin will stop the water loss and that protect the plant. Okay, clear? Maybe you have seen, know that cork that is used to what we can say that stoppers are there, no? Bottle stoppers, the shuttle cork. Maybe you have heard the word, no? Cork. In many products, we can see the cork, like our cap is there, no? The cork is there. So this cork protect inside material from the outer environment. Okay. So all these about the cork simple tissues, in which dead cells are present, no intercellular spaces. They are also protecting the plant from injuries, germs and water loss, as they are having one chemical that is called as suberin. Okay, in epidermis, the cutin is there, cutin, the waxy substance. Okay, so like that we have completed our third session, and I hope that all the types of the simple tissues you just understand. Okay, we will revise, don't afraid, we will revise the thing. Now your homework is that first you have to write how the permanent tissues form, but not from the slide. Whatever you have learned, Watch the session again and again, listen to the session again and again, and then write how permanent tissues are formed. Then again you have to make one table. You have to write type of simple permanent tissue, location, structure and function. Okay, clear? So this is your today's homework. Please do your homework on time. I know that these are the lengthy sessions. I can understand, but we don't have option. Okay, we have to learn. Okay, these are important sessions. Okay, so please do your study on time. If you have any doubt, ask me anytime. We will discuss on that. Also, we will discuss all these things in live session also. Okay, still stay home, stay safe, and thank you.